All right, guys, we are back. Good evening, good morning, or good afternoon. As always, it is so great to see you. And friends, well, today we're at O'Neill National, or excuse me, Regional Park. And this is just a quick overnight trip. We are here for three reasons. Great timing on the crow flying by. Anyway, so as many of you may have watched the Alabama Hills episode, that was where Caleb and I went off for three weeks ago. We went up to Alabama Hills and we were supposed to roast some marshmallows. We didn't get to do that. So we're here to roast some marshmallows. Second, Caleb's cousin, Hero, who has never been camping, so he gets to camp with us tonight. And third, we're here to test out a Russian bear hot tent, and it has a stove in it, so this could be a lot of fun. So in a moment here, we're gonna get everything all set up and we're gonna get things rocking. So let's get on to it. Well, in order to get to the tent, well, I gotta move all this firewood first, and, well, might as well unload the turtleback as well. Alright, so I have one of these RV sand-free mats. That's the blue mat that you see me getting set up on. These mats, by the way, I highly, highly recommend. They're a little pricey. I think I paid $109 for that. It's an 8x14 or something like that. But all dirt kind of falls through it. And this is before I actually have the mat that goes along with the tent itself. So I'm using this as a little bit of a base. And as you can see, unfolding this tent is super, super easy. You just plop it down and you have these legs that you just kind of fold out. And in a moment, you're gonna see me jumping inside of this thing, and that's where the magic happens. All right, so we got the tent out here. And so the next step with this is you get it kind of unpopped out or kind of unfolded out, and I'm gonna get inside there. You're gonna pop the top of it up. There's this rod in there that apparently you untwist, pull it out of there, that locks it in place. And then we have, I think there's 8 arms that we just simply pop out and boom. So I don't know whether this should be a timed setup, but keep a note on the time and how long it's gonna take for me to put this thing up. So here we go. All right, so as soon as I get into this thing here, basically what I'm going to be doing, I'm kind of walk you through, there's a pole inside of this thing that I'm going to screw in there, or I'm sorry, there's a pole that's already in there rather, and you just kind of pop it up. It's kind of like an umbrella. It works exactly how an umbrella works. And actually this part right here, I will say, is a little, requires a little bit of strength to get this thing to pop out because it's a pretty big roof there. But once I do, as you can see, now it's just a matter of going around. You can see me popping out all those legs. This thing really, again, is a breeze to set up. And of course the kids want to go piling in there right away. Now, the last thing that is left is a door. Yeah, this thing has a swinging door. And so you just pop out the center of the door here, which kind of locks it into place. And on the right-hand side of it, it has a Velcro on it, kind of a two-sided Velcro strip that goes along the length of it. And on the tent, there's 2 pieces of Velcro that allow you to sandwich the door within it. So that's how the hinge mechanism is going to work. Just kind of open it up, seal the Velcro, and boom, you are off to the races. And as you're gonna see here, this thing works really, really well. To lock the door, you have a flap that kind of goes around the perimeter of the door. You just kind of seal it in there, and yeah, it works pretty awesome. Okay, as you can see there, this thing went up crazy fast, guys. So literally, it pops into place. So now I'm gonna put some spikes down into the ground, although I really don't think we need it. Get the fireplace set up in here, and we're gonna get some chow going. All right, now it's time to put the stove together. This is, you know, I have to give this company credit. Everything is really quite intuitive. And I have to say,
one of the things that I'm looking out for, especially with something like this, is how well everything kind of fits together. How well do all the seams kind of butt together, the metalwork and so forth. And so far, I have to say, everything is actually pretty darn impressive. And I think that's actually quite an understatement. This thing came in a... The stove actually came in this big wooden crate, which was awesome, which I'm gonna dual purpose that as the quiet box, or the quiet box for the generator 2.0. So the first one, I used that Rubbermaid case, and it had that heat shield inside of it, which honestly, it got a little warm, so probably wasn't the best idea. But this is looking pretty darn impressive, guys. Okay. And that's the cool thing. I like stuff that you can put together and not have to fuss about directions and wondering that you're hoping like hell you're putting it together right. Okay, so now we got that. Boom.
And here we are. This is my second outing with Top Knives, their high impact hatchet. And this thing, of course, is an absolute blast to use. Fire started. Now it's time to get some mac and cheese and hot dogs going. One of the things that, if you know me or watch this channel enough, you're going to find out I really love to cook. Now, granted, I like to cook a lot of gourmet stuff. And guys, I'm going to tell you right now, this is one of those meals. There's nothing gourmet about this. But you know what? Sometimes it's the simplicity of the meal that makes it absolute magic. And of course, in the back of the turtle back here, I'm cooking up some mac and cheese here for the boys. And in a moment, we're going to be cooking hot dogs over the fire with sticks. So this is going to be a good old-fashioned bonding meal with my son and, of course, his cousin. And if I'm being honest, guys, I haven't cooked a hot dog over an open flame since I was a kid. Remember in the Alabama Hills episode, I was telling you about some of my most magical times were when I was a kid camping and so forth. Guys, I've not experienced this and be able to share this kind of just old-fashioned cooking like this with my son. I know, but you know what? It was special for me, and my son, he absolutely loved it. Granted, his hot dog almost fell off the stick as well. Dinner's cooked, and now it's time for marshmallows. I broke out the original fire reflector because it's getting cooler out, and so this thing really works because what it does, guys, is it bounces back. It kind of amplifies the amount of heat coming off of that, and it worked really, really well. Kept the boys really toasty as they toasted some marshmallows. Okay, so the marshmallows are cooked. Dinner's cooked, and now we're just winding down. The hot water heater is cooking on the turtleback trailer, and once that is warmed up, I'm going to do the dishes. Then we're going to call it a night. Give you an update on this Russian bear tent. This thing is absolutely amazing, and so we're going to step inside here. So it is about more than 35. Okay, it is 49 degrees out. And inside of here, it is a toasty 81 degrees. So this thing, and I have two windows open. I have both windows on both sides. There's these windows right there. And right now we have that open. And I just cracked open this other door over here. So this tent is extremely efficient, and of course we don't have there's a decent sized fire in there, and I do have that little, let's see if we can get closer where you can see it, one of those thermal, and of course it's not going to pick up here. All right, so I'll put on the screen here, it's one of those thermal fans, so as the bottom of it heats up, it creates this energy that spins the motor, and so that's kicking off a lot, throwing a lot of the heat around and so forth. But what makes this tent really amazing is
I didn't pretty much see much here in the dark, but there's actually two layers here. So whereas most tents are going to have a single layer, and that layer is like the outer layer of this, you can feel the inside of it. It's quite cool to the touch, and actually there's some condensation on it. This has two layers, so it acts as an insulator. And so the outside, again, when I run my hands on the backside of the outside layer, I can feel coolness and a little condensation. Inside, man, it's just warm. So, yeah, super, super, super impressed with this thing. If you're gonna use the wood stove, you really have to, like in temperatures like this, you really have to keep a small flame, or just really, because you can almost, there's that nose, let me see, that nose right here, this that cone comes off, and you have a series of holes right there. So, yeah, things pretty warm. So, the cool part about it is they give you these handy gloves. So, if you watch this, so of course I remove that, and of course it allows a bunch of oxygen in there, which makes the fire bigger. Now if I put this back on and it starts covering up more of those holes right there, you can start seeing it kind of snuffs the fire out. Remove it, boom, ton of oxygen in there. Close it up and it goes down.
Not really breaking news here, but just goes to point that, let me see if I can get myself in. Here we go. So it just goes to show, just got to figure out the right, and it all really depends on the ambient temperature outside as well. But it is super roomy in here. It is super, it's comfortable. So yeah, looking forward to this night's sleep. Got to figure out again how to get the temps down to the 70s, which would be perfect. And we're going to be good to go. So with that said, unless there's something crazy that happened, but you know, actually something crazy did happen earlier. I wish I had the cameras running, but I didn't. As I was walking over to the Turtleback trailer to check in the mac and cheese, a meteorite, I assume it was a meteorite or a satellite or something, was burning up through the sky and just pieces of it falling off. So if anybody knows what that was, it's 10 p.m. right now. It was about 8, so about 2 hours ago, 8 p.m. On the 20th. So if you happen to know what that was, cool. Anyways, again, assuming nothing goes wrong, I'll see you guys in the morning. All right, it is 7 a.m. Had a pretty decent night of sleep last night. It got down pretty cold. Actually, the temps were down in the low 30s. The funny thing is, now while the stove in there requires, you know, I had to put wood in it a couple times through the night, that tent is extremely efficient. It was on, typically, put on the screen here, about 80 degrees inside while it was like 37 degrees outside. It was definitely, it kept the heat really nice. Actually, and that temperature right there is based upon two doors open and two windows open. And so you had a constant flow of fresh air coming in and it remained really, really warm. Now, it's time to get some coffee going, and we're gonna scoot back a little early today because the little guy has a birthday party to attend. But so far, super impressed with this tent. Now, with breakfast cooking, you may be wondering, Alex, did you make some gourmet coffee? Did you pour it a Chemex, a French press, or some sort of pour over? Nope, I went full on lazy today. Kind of a Keurig style coffee machine plugged into the inverter in the Turtleback trailer, and boom, off we go. Well, it was pretty good coffee either way. What's funny, you may know, my wife got me the scuttle for my birthday. Was it Christmas or birthday last year? Either way, I've only had this for a handful of months, and guys, I absolutely love this thing. So in this particular case, I cooked the bacon and potatoes on the scuttle, and on the stove on the Turtleback trailer, well, I cooked the eggs on that, and hell, we're off to the races. All right, now it's time to take the tent down. And what I'm going to do here, because when I watch review videos on things like this, I hate when they speed it up, because especially if I want to find out how long it takes to put up something or take down, I want to see that. And if I want to speed the video up, at least I can tell legitimately how long it took. So in this case, guys, I'm not going to speed up anything. So if you want to kind of fast forward down below. Otherwise, you can see how long it's going to take me to put this tent down. Now, what I've just done is I kicked in all the legs, all those buckled all those legs in, and now I'm just reversing the process inside of the tent. So just like an umbrella, I'm going to pull that centerpiece down. Now I will say, watch where you have your hands, because you can pinch your the palm of your hands if you have it in the path of that bar coming down. So just be careful with that. And as I go around, because the mat that I had didn't cover the tent entirely, so I'm taking my time here. I just want to get as much of the dirt and the debris off of this thing before I go packing it away. But again, as you're seeing, we're just reversing the steps that we took when we put it up. So all the legs are now being folded inwards towards the main center rod itself. And you pull everything up to the top here. And with the exception, as I'm watching this and doing this voiceover at the same time here, I'm realizing I probably could have let some of this that air out before I got to this part here. Because, of course, I'm going to have to sit on this and let all that air kind of drain out of there before you have this kind of cinch strap that goes around it that makes it super, super easy to put this thing back into the bag. Now, one of the things I do want to add here is the weight of this tent. It actually doesn't weigh as much as you would expect. So the tent itself is about 67 pounds. So considering the size of this thing, I think the weight is very manageable. And here I am, of course, giving this thing a bear hug, trying to get all that air out of there. Now here is what I consider the magic. Raise your hand if you've ever put up a tent or anything camping and it's a pain in the ass to get it back in the original bag that it came. This part right here, guys, hands down, I've given this company a lot of praise because they legitimately deserve it. But this by far is one of my favorite things about this tent. You can get it back in the bag without having to, you know, really put a lot of effort into it. So it goes back into the bag super easy. And as you can see, right to the right of me there are two straps. So once it's in here, I'm going to cinch it down. And friends, we're off to the races. Everything's all packed. And now it is time to hit the road. All right, guys, so this was a crash and run morning. Caleb has a birthday event that he has to go to this afternoon, so
turn left,
really
on the El Toro Road.
Had to make breakfast, pack up, and didn't do as much filming as I wanted to do, but I wanted to give you a snapshot of
continue
how
on
the
El Toro Road for
all
one
the
mile.
Care went. Specifically, as I shared with you last night, one of the biggest things that we wanted to test here today was indeed the Russian bear tent and the stove that was inside of it. I wasn't expecting really cold weather, but it actually got down to, as you see, 37 degrees outside. And the biggest challenge I had, I think I mentioned this earlier, was regulating the temperature inside the stove. So that's something I'm gonna have to build up a little bit more experience on, you know, the types of wood, how much wood, the amount of air that is actually put into that little nozzle on the front of the stove that regulates the airflow going in. Because it was, at many times, it was hot. At the peak, it was 88 degrees inside that tent, which of course is very, very warm. So, from a construction standpoint, these guys really, there's not much they didn't think of. One of the things I meant to bring up is
in the center of the tent, you have this netting up there, which works perfectly to have your USB powered light hanging from there and whatever else that you want. In addition to that, there's all sorts of little pockets and
in
so forth.
In a quarter mile, turn right onto Glen Ranch Road.
And in addition to that, they have all these little pockets with a little Velcro that you can put all over the place. And there's these little hooks on each of the arms inside the tent that really makes it nice if you want to hang up things or this or that. In addition to that, the only other item
turn
that
right onto Glen Ranch Road.
The only other item that we were testing out was that king camping queen size cot, which I was pretty surprised because on Amazon it had 4 stars out of 5.
Continue on Glen Ranch Road for 1.5 miles.
Let her finish. And the negative reviews that were on there were relating to people saying it was uncomfortable because that center bracing. I don't know why people are griping about that, because something that wide, you need that center bracing there. So it worked out well. I was on one end, Caleb and Hero were on the other, and the Mega Duo Matt did perfect on top of that. So again, overall, it was really a great outing. The only thing that was a little whoops is when I left, and what's funny about this, because I had the Turtleback trailer charged in, topping off the batteries, and I kept thinking to myself, I gotta fill the water because I drained the water last time that when I parked it, and I didn't do that. So as you can imagine, because I'm making a point of it here, we get down to pick up some firewood. I'm like, oh dang it, I forgot to put water in it. And I'm telling you, once you head out with hot water, it's tough to go camping with it. I know how that sounds, but case in point, all the dishes are dirty. But we did turn it back around, and I did probably put about 5 minutes of water in. It wasn't 5 minutes of water, maybe about 3 minutes of water into it. So that lasted. These guys were washing their hands like 40 times yesterday, and then we did the dishes from dinner last night. But we did run out of water this morning because I only had maybe a few gallons put into the tanks. But other than that, it was a very successful camping outing, and I definitely think we're going to be coming here again because it's only 15 minutes away from where I live. So this is really fantastic to be able to get out, test gear if it's if I don't have the time to go heading out on a longer trip. It also gets the little guys out as well. So anyways, guys, this is it. Thanks for coming along. Hope you enjoyed this. And final note, yes, highly recommend these Russian Bear tents. So far, it's a breeze to put up. Actually, it goes up super fast. I'm floored that you can get the darn thing into the bag afterwards. And I did realize that I didn't put the door. So the later on today, I do have to open up that bag again and put the door in because I forgot to put the door in. But everything fits in super, super nice. All right, on that note, we're going to close it off there, and we'll see you guys next time.
Bye.